5 OBS plugins to step up your content, whether you're recording or live streaming using OBS Studio. Today, I want to talk about a couple of plugins that I've been using personally, and I also want to give you some example cases of when you can use them. I am also going to put some honorable mentions, mostly plugins that I haven't started using yet, so make sure you watch till the end so you can catch those. Let's hear a message from our sponsor, and then we can begin. I don't think I need to tell you about the importance of first impressions. Well, today's sponsor, Owned, will help you make that first impression. There is something as an amateur look, but with Own, you don't have to worry about that anymore. You'll get full overlay packs, sometimes designed to match your favorite games. Whether you're an FPS player or an indie game enthusiast, Own literally has everything you need, including animated emotes. Your livestream alerts could be looking super fresh. And if you don't like pre-made stuff, that's fine, because there's multiple makers on their website. You can make your own emotes, your own custom badges with their badge maker, your own team logo, and even an avatar. Owned offers much, much more, but I'll let you check it out over at own.gg/gaellevel. That is own3d.gg/gaellevel. Okay, so plugin number one is going to be the Move Transition plugin by Exeldro. And although, as the name suggests, it's great for transitioning from scene to scene, moving your sources in different positions, I mostly use it, and if you watch my content, you would know, to simply move sources within the same scene so I can accomplish specific effects. I usually pair that with a channel point trigger through StreamerBot, and that's how I got the anime split screen effect. That's how I got the most recent album cover effect. That's how I did the JoJo pose effect. But I still believe it's great as a scene-to-scene transition, especially for video podcasts. In one of my videos showcasing the Move Transition tool, I showed you an example of how you can apply it. And honestly, I can't wait to set it up for myself so I can use it for my podcast. All right, plugin number two is Atom Vertical. You probably heard about it. I made a video about it. Everyone made a video about it. But it's that famous plugin that allows you to basically create content vertically within your same OBS window. It allows you to stream, record, and also basically save playbacks. I don't use it for streaming because TikTok, for example, does not give away stream keys anymore. I could use it to stream on something like Instagram, but I just don't stream on Instagram. So the most valuable feature for me is actually the recording feature. On some separate channels that I have, I tend to record normal mode, basically landscape mode, but also portrait thanks to Atom Vertical. And then when I edit, I actually stack them up and then edit the whole thing together. So I have two formats, two videos, but I only have to edit once. But it also helps from time to time you have an idea for like a TikTok and you want to just hop on your computer and record it and export it. Okay, plugin number three is Face Tracker by Norihiro. And it's kind of ironic that it's on the list because it's currently not working for me on OBS 29.1. But I did make a video showcasing it when it was working, and it's such an amazing tool. I feel like it's especially useful for people who desperately want those cameras that come with a gimbal. I will be reviewing one soon, but can't afford them. The Face Tracker plugin does the exact same thing. The only problem is that it's an OBS plugin, so you're limited to using it with OBS. But come on, you know OBS has a virtual camera. You can just set a scene, boom, put the face tracker, and then use that for your Zoom calls. Okay, so plugin number four is StreamFX. And hold up, hear me out. I'm aware that right now the StreamFX creator has put the whole plugin behind a paywall through a Patreon or something that's like 10 bucks per month, which is, you know, ridiculous. But at first I started defending it. I was like, hey, you know what? If you love the plugin so much, why not pay for it? Blah, blah, blah. Apparently the creator was rude. There was some weird exchange with the users and stuff like that. So this is not an endorsement. The reason why I put it on the list is because Nutty has made a video showing you a bunch of plugins that replace basically the options that StreamFX would give you. So yes, number four on the list is actually bringing you to Nutty's video that's going to give you a bunch of other plugins. StreamFX would allow you to blur a source. It would allow you to use like the corner pin tool in order to put it like in 3D space. One that I used a lot was the shader filter that allows me to basically do some color grading on my footage. I believe it had some stylized filters like drop shadow, outline, and things like that. But yeah, it's one plugin that basically gives you a bunch of options, but nothing is keeping you from getting those options from somewhere else. By the way, if you know how to code and how to make OBS plugins, Hey, slide in my DM somewhere. There's a lot of things to be done. Plugin number 5 is something for creators like me who want to show their input. It's input overlay or input history. I personally use it for when I'm using things like Photopea or Photoshop in order to show exactly what shortcut I'm pressing. But of course, if you're a gamer and you just want to show people your inputs while you're playing the game, it's also super useful. Especially if you live stream without a webcam, it gives people something to look at just a little bit. Okay, when it comes to honorable mentions, first of all, I would like to shout out Exeldro because he makes so many plugins for OBS and they're all so good. The next plugin I'm looking at right now is the freeze filter because that's something I should have been using a while ago. In my recent tutorials, I show you how I actually take screenshots in order to have still images through StreamerBot and it's a whole process. But with the freeze filter, apparently you can just activate a filter and boom, you have your screenshot. I haven't started using it yet, but I'm guessing like the whole difference is that it freezes the video source and it doesn't create like an actual screenshot. So my method is not completely obsolete if you actually want to save those screenshots in a specific file. The other one I'm looking at is Recursion Effect, and it looks like so much fun. From what I can see, it basically allows you to create that effect that you saw in music videos such as September. So what's not to like about that? Maybe you do only need a green screen because I'm guessing like, you know, it doesn't cut you out. So having some sort of transparency is basically needed in order to use that properly. And the other one that I'm looking at is the Time Warp Scan. It's basically that famous like TikTok effect where there's a bar going down, scanning down and basically freezing. So you can do all sorts of cool effects to have a final image. I think that's a great idea for like a channel point redemption. So I'll probably be using that in the future, in the near future. And there you go. That is 5 OBS plugins to help you step up your game when it comes to recording or live streaming. If you want to use any of those, there will be links in the description. One thing that I ask from you is do your best to try to support those creators, the people who make those plugins, because they are mostly free, except for one. If you use a specific filter that you find very useful, let me know in the comment section below. I'm always down to discovering new stuff. Also, when you go watch Nutty's video, make sure you click on that subscribe button and follow me on Twitch. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you all next time. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.